As if there's anybody left alive to, at the end of the century, to write the history of the 21st century, Trump will be one of the biggest villains. But the trouble is, withdrawing from the Paris Agreement encourages everybody else to withdraw as well, and that helps to ensure that, that we're going to be wiped out.
I'll give a slight counter point to that, which is that we are in a position of pushback, a position of extreme pushback on the damage that Donald Trump is doing to the American reputation, the American system of values. I can't say to the American economy because I don't study it, but I think he's also damaging the American economy to the favor of enriching the already richest and impoverishing the middle class.
We've got our own very own acts of major league stupidity going on in this country.
Yeah, again, I have not studied Brexit at all, but I hold the contrary opinion that anything that is damaging to any major economy of the world enhances our chances of survival, because the economic engine of the world is what's killing us. And I will repeat that at every opportunity, so more and more people get it, that you can't have a society which enriches people based upon the destruction of nature functioning well, with 7 billion people all trying to claw nature apart in order to get financial wealth. You can't eat money.
Yes.
And it's not even paper money. You might conceivably be able to fry and salt paper money and eat it. But it's cyber. Money is cyber cash now. Not, I'm not talking about Bitcoin. I'm talking about the money you have in the bank is ciphers in someone's ledger.
Yeah.
So let me switch to the dire parts of the predictions. You know, you said a moment ago, or a few moments ago, if any of us are left by the end of the century. So where do you see us headed, and with what probability do you see us headed there?
Well, I guess I've been asked this a couple of times the last couple of days, and it's a very difficult question, because it's either going to be a complete disaster, or we're going to be able to save ourselves, and it's not clear which. Because the first thing is, if we carry on the way we're going, we've had it, and all of this, let's reduce our carbon emissions according to the promises made in Paris, just won't work. I mean, the reductions, first of all, are not taking place, because carbon dioxide levels are rising at an accelerating rate, and you see that with the more and lower data, and all the promises made by governments for the Paris Agreement are just what they make them, but what they really mean is, our successors might do something, but we don't have to do anything now, because it's not going to, the totting up is not going to be done until 2050. Well, 2052, I think. And so they can get away with a lot for a long time.
We are mightily kicking the can down the road. Not just kicking it down the road, but mightily. We're kicking it way down the road to 2052.
It offers the possibility that they could agree on a tighter effort, but I think it's unlikely, and especially with the US leaving it. And then also just this reducing CO2 emissions is just not easy. If it was easy, they'd have done it. It's like deciding that we would stop producing CFCs because it's producing the ozone hole. That was an easy decision to make, because there were substitute chemicals for CFCs, so they did it, and to save the world from the ozone hole. But saving the world from climate change via reducing CO2 emissions is not easy, because if you, you know, you, well, I guess you're in Hawaii, but I was in California, and you just have to look at a Los Angeles freeway, and you realize, how is the human race going to live without this? It's made a world which is a kind of nightmare world, completely dependent on fossil fuels for keeping everything going, because building lots of buildings a long way apart from each other means you have to travel around in a car to get from A to B. Everything is predicated on ready availability of fossil fuels so that you can drive everywhere. And that can't be undone. The shape of cities, unless you're prepared to demolish all the world's cities and rebuild them in a sensible way, which we can't do, you're stuck with the cities that we've got. There's built-in climate change horrors just in our urban infrastructure.
So, but you a moment ago, you said there was an alternative that we might survive, which is good news to me. I regard your opinions very, very highly. So what might be that path through? Let everything collapse, but collapse, I mean, everything. Let the heat engine that is the California freeway system and all like it, let that somehow implode and yet still be able to hope that there's enough carbon sequestration going on to keep us out of 4 degrees centigrade, or?
Well, that's what I would say is our only hope is not reducing carbon emissions, because we won't do it. It's taking carbon out of the atmosphere, direct air capture of carbon dioxide. So, and that is a massively expensive task. It's not even clear that it's practically feasible, although it does look as if it is from the pilot studies that are being done, but it has to be made a lot cheaper. But that can be done with a lot of engineering research. So we can, if we really put our minds to it and make it the biggest thing that we do, bigger than military research, bigger than anything else, is design a practicable and cost-effective method of removing CO2 from the atmosphere by air capture. And then if we apply that, we can save ourselves, because what's the villain, what's doing it, all this climate change horrors, is carbon dioxide in the atmosphere, because plus methane and other things. But if you can get rid of the carbon dioxide, we've got rid of the greenhouse effect, and we can save ourselves. So it's the last ditch, because we can't, we ought to be able to live in a sustainable way, in harmony with the environment and so on, and do it that way. But we don't, we're too stupid to do that, too greedy and selfish, and we won't do it, and it's not going to happen. So the only way we can save ourselves is to use our engineering skills, our technical skills, to design our direct air capture systems that will work and will get us off the hook by removing CO2 from the atmosphere. That's what I put my faith in. I mean, I don't normally put my faith in techno fixes, but that's our last ditch hope. And it ought to work, because the methods that are being used now in the pilot studies in Iceland and British Columbia are the same as it, they're working, they're removing CO2. What you need is to think this is like solar energy was 10 years ago. The expense, it works, but it's incredibly expensive. Now solar energy is incredibly cheap, because enough money was put into technical research to find new ways of producing solar energy. So we can do the same. If we put enough money and effort into air capture of CO2, we can achieve that. And we have to spend a large fraction of the global domestic product on it, but we will be able to do it, and it would get rid of enough CO2 to stop the climate from warming more. So we can get off the hook by doing a techno fix, so long as we do it absolutely with all our effort and all our money and all our engineering skills, and don't waste our effort on something else like designing a new weapon system or something.
Or flying to Mars.
Yes, yeah, Mars is not going to be a place to escape to.
I was going to say, that seems to be an attractive alternative to the mega-riches. You know, they're booking passage on Elon Musk's, whatever. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. I also hear that, I mean, people, you know, float rumors about how the uber-rich have bunkers in New Zealand with, you know, where they can survive for a matter of years before coming up. Well, those might work in the event that the problem was a nuclear war, but they won't work very well if the problem is a 4 degree centigrade hotter world. There's, you know, you can come up in 2 years and it'll still be impossible to grow anything.
My faith in the human race is that we are a very ingenious species, really creative, ingenious, and brilliant at anything involving things and technical stuff. But we're no good at human relations or anything involving sort of moral approaches. Yeah. So we've got ourselves into a terrible mess through our own greed and stupidity. But we can get out of it by our ingenuity. That's my faith, is a partial faith in the human race, but we have one set of characteristics which can save us, while all the other characteristics are destroying us.